Let's break down the appropriate mindset to have when you're undergoing meal prep. So many of us just focus on how time consuming it will be, or maybe even how hard it's gonna be, without giving any energy to the benefits of meal prep. And when you give energy to the benefits, you're gonna feel more motivated and actually enthusiastic about taking all of your meals in your own hands and not having to fall short because of impulse. What's up, my free and powerful friends? I'm Magnify Maggie. I'm the creator of the Magnify Method. The Magnify Method helps you think different in order to drink different or never again. I've got so many resources down in the description. Check out the links. I help clients with nutrition, fitness, and mindset so that they can get fit while they cut back or even quit. I ain't gonna blow steam up your ass. Meal prep does take time. Meal prep is an investment into your health and wellness for that week. Today, we're gonna break down some strategies, but more importantly, the overall perception that you need to have about meal prep in order to do it successfully, consistently, and enthusiastically. Unless you're already in the habitual routine of meal prepping, it's very likely that you have a pretty blah attitude around it. And so you will have to practice. You're gonna have to practice shifting your thoughts and really focusing on the benefits. Benefits of meal prepping, maybe just taking 2.5 to 3 hours on Sunday afternoon to prepare yourself for the week, cuts down on meal costs. But more importantly, for me at least, it cuts down on the mental stress of making decisions in the moment. For me, I'm really go, go, go in the morning, and even come lunchtime, I really only have about 30 minutes between calls. So I need to have something ready, but I also need to have something already in mind. If I'm stuck in indecision purgatory, I might spend that whole 30 minutes just trying to hem and haw about, what am I gonna eat? I don't feel like that. So then I'm actually wasting a ton of time and mental energy. So when you meal prep, you've basically already committed and made that decision for what you're having for breakfast on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, what you're doing for lunch, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. You don't have to make those decisions in the moment, and you'll find that it's so easy, you get excited because all you have to do is go to your fridge and then maybe heat something up and you are ready to rock and roll. Another great aspect to meal prep is impulse control. I touched a little bit on the money saving aspect, but when you think about the times that you go to work without having a plan in store for what you're gonna eat that day, then a lot of times you're going to find yourself at the Chinese buffet with your coworkers or driving through Mickey D's, getting your food through a window. And the more times you do that, the less likely you are to feel proud of your decisions and accomplished about your progress, both mental health and physical health. You're gonna feel pretty lackadaisical, pretty sad about the decisions that you made that day. Okay, let's get into the nitty gritty. We're gonna talk the strategies to meal prep, and I don't personally think that there is any wrong or right way to meal prep. You might find that the strategies that I advise you with today, you actually go away and create somewhat of a hybrid program. You might take a little bit from this strategy and a little bit from that strategy and make it your own. Feel free to do that because my lifestyle is not the same as yours. So you might have to pick and choose some of the helpful things from a bunch of different varieties. The first strategy is probably the most typical, and that is going grocery shopping, say every Sunday morning, and getting home and getting into the kitchen right away. Something that I really encourage you to do is to have your list ready, go to the store, and when you get home, put on some positive tunes. Get some high vibes going so that you really get into the energy of, man, I feel good having control over what I eat. Man, I feel so organized making sure that I have my meals prepped. Man, I'm gonna feel so much better when I choose to eat this healthy meal over going to Burger King. So you get the high vibe music going and then you just get to work. I actually have a meal prep guide that walks you through how to actually do it from A through Z. When you get into the house, washing your veggies, what type of Tupperware do you need? When do you turn your oven on to preheat? How do you cook your starches versus your veggies versus your protein? If you need any of that, Check out the link in the description. You can sign up for this meal prep guide. Like I said, it goes through steps A through Z, and you even have a weekly meal planner. The font probably isn't bright enough to show on camera here, but you have a weekly meal planner to strategize and actually map out your decisions. Remember, you're making decisions now so that you save yourself probably hours throughout the week of hemming and hawing about what you're gonna eat. So, like I said, that guide is gonna be able to teach you exactly how to orchestrate the bulk meal prep. Now, another strategy that we find most helpful in Casa de la Gensón is where we select two meals a week that we are going to cook at home. We usually say Monday and Tuesday nights, we are committing to making dinner together and then having leftovers, AKA lazy meal prep. So on Monday night, we cook big steaks. We make that our grill night. We cook big steaks, big enough to where I'm only gonna eat a third to maybe a half. Then I've got that half or two thirds left for lunches Tuesday and Wednesday. Then let's say on Tuesday night, we have taco night. That's our favorite. You know, what do you know? Taco Tuesday. And every Tuesday we switch out the protein. We'll do beef tacos, we'll do shrimp tacos, chicken tacos, carne asada tacos. But we make enough of that protein and whatever our side item is so that I can have lunch Wednesday, Thursday, and even Friday. Sometimes we make it in such high volume that will also cover my bases for dinner Wednesday, dinner Thursday. So again, I'm just not having to make those decisions constantly. And that actually sits pretty well with us because we don't need new meals every day. We're pretty routine, and what I have Tuesday night, I am fine and dandy with having on Wednesday afternoon as lunch because that's just the routine I'm in and it frees me up so much time. Here's another idea, and that is cooking theme nights. So whether you go ahead and meal prep everything on Sunday or you actually cook throughout the week, just a few nights here and there, decide what theme each day is. I've kind of pointed out what our theme is on Monday, grill night. Taco night is Tuesday. Wednesday night is pasta night, and you can switch out the different proteins. Have beef, chicken, shrimp. Again, get creative. And then Thursday night is oftentimes our bake night. So we'll do baked chicken, baked salmon, anything that goes in the oven on a pan. We like to do those as like one sheet pan kind of meals. There's so many out there. Now you could do these every night, or again, you could have all of these things going simultaneously on Sundays. You could have chicken in the oven while you are maybe boiling your pasta or your rice for your pasta night. You could have the shrimp on the stove sauteing for your taco night. So you can have all of these done ahead of time. That would just be more of an advanced level when you get really comfortable with it so that you do have that variety throughout the week. Now I've touched on the fact that I'm all about high protein. So I just wanna give you guys some good rules of thumb. Remember that when you're prepping your protein portions, 1 ounce of cooked animal meat is roughly 7 grams of protein. So you want to ensure that you have at least 5 ounces of animal style protein for every meal. As adults, we need anywhere from 25 to 35 grams of protein just to push our bodies into what's called muscle protein synthesis. And so when we're wanting to build muscle, regenerate our tissue, and really get the most out of our meals, we wanna aim for that high protein content. So again, bigger portions of chicken, steak, and fish than you're probably used to. But when you do that, you actually don't want as much of the pasta, the potatoes, the fats. You really make protein the star. When it comes to breakfast foods, a lot of times we opt for eggs and we think that 1 or 2 eggs is gonna suffice as our protein source for the day. But did you know that eggs are actually only about 6 grams of protein? And if you're eating a whole egg, it's about 50% protein, 50% fat. That's why egg whites are really promoted. So you wanna have the equivalent of about 5 eggs, whether that be 2 whole eggs and then the equivalent of 3 egg whites, or if you have the calorie budget and you need the fat content, go ahead and do 5 whole eggs. I know I do. So go ahead and really play around with your portions and you'll find that you're not succumbing to cravings throughout the day. You're full and satisfied and energized throughout the day, and you're gonna start to see your body shape change because your muscles are growing, and the more muscle you have, the less fat you have. Okay, I'm gonna be really transparent that although we do love to cook and have that time where we are eating throughout the week together, sometimes when we are busy, we just like to order our meals. I am so grateful that I finally found a meal prep company here local to Vegas that provides meals in the appropriate portions. So every meal by Hugo Lauren has a minimum of 35 grams of protein, and most of them actually have over 40 grams of protein. A lot of times in the past, I would order some meals, Foodie Fit, all of these different brands where the portion sizes were so small, somewhat comparable to like a Lean Cuisine. I felt like I needed to eat two or three of them just to feel a little bit full. So I love that we vetted out an appropriate meal prep company. And remember, if you ever need help with this, make sure you schedule that nutrition consultation because I can help you find a food prep service in your town or even on a national level. There's a great brand called Icon Meals. Just make sure that they give you enough food so that you're not starving your ass off all day. All right, again, meal prep really comes down to the mindset. If you can believe that the time investment is gonna be worth it, you're gonna find so many benefits. But to get started, there is absolutely no shame in getting this guide and following it step by step so that you make sure that you feel organized and you are just checking the boxes as you go. Again, so much information on appropriate portion sizing in here, and then even down to the nitty-gritty of your Tupperware that you would use. You wanna get this, the description to sign up, or sorry, the link to sign up is in the description below, so you can have all of these strategies at your fingertips, including three healthy recipes, what? And that shopping list and weekly meal planner. This is gonna set you up for success. And until next time, make sure that you subscribe. We're dropping all kinds of nutrition and fitness education just like this. And go ahead and leave your comment. I wanna know which tip here was most helpful and when are you gonna use it for your own personal meal prep? This Sunday? We'll see. Make sure you check back in with us. I cannot wait to see you soon. Remember to think different in order to drink different, or never again.